little scientists. I'm Professor Bill Tyson, and together we're gonna know different forms of science. We've already talked about the physical states of matter: solid, liquid, and gaseous. We've also talked about the density of matter. It's time to warm things up and see how density behaves. When the molecules are moving, they need some space to move and end up getting away from each other. But when they have low agitation, they organize themselves so they can become closer together. When they move away, we call it thermal expansion. And when they come closer, we call thermocontraction. Then, the higher the temperature, the lower the density. And the lower the temperature, the higher the density. But this doesn't happen with all substances. There's a substance that doesn't fit this rule: the water. Have you ever noticed that when put ice in the water, it floats? It's because the density of the ice is smaller than the density of the water. When a substance passes into a solid state, it organizes itself so that its molecules occupy a certain order, so that there's a smaller space between them. But with water, it's different. When it solidifies, its organization leaves empty spaces between the molecules, which causes the water being denser than the ice. So, the density of the water is 1 gram per cubic centimeter, and the ice has a density of 0.9 grams per cubic centimeter, which makes the ice float. Hey, how about an icy water? That's it for now. See you next time! Hey guys, show a little scientist that studying science can be fun. Share this video and become my patron.